Hello all the students, welcome to the online course of Matrix Methods of Structural Analysis. Now in previous video we have completed the very first problem of frame using structure approach of stiffness matrix method. Now let us see the second problem using the same method, structure approach of stiffness matrix method. So here is the problem statement. Analyze the rigid frame using structure approach of stiffness matrix method. Take EI constant. Neglect axial deformation. So here this frame is given, ABCD frame, member AB, member BC and member CD. Inertia is varying. For AB and CD member, inertia is given I, while for member BC, inertia is given 2I. Only member BC is loaded with this 75 kN load and a horizontal load at beam level that is applied 50 kN. That is load given. Okay. Now to start with solution, very first step, that is to calculate degree of freedom. So looking at the figure, you can see that frame, it is, though it is similar in geometry and boundary condition, and but loading, okay, loading it is not given symmetrical. Also at beam level there is no any restraint provided. So this frame it is categorized as sway frame. That means delta that is there. Delta is present for column. So here delta, this frame is a sway frame. Therefore delta is one unknown. The first unknown is delta. And next unknowns, that is looking at the joint, each joint, support A and D are fixed support. So there is no degree of freedom, while support B and C, they are pin support. Okay, all joints of frame are pin supported joint. So at each joint B and C, there will be one rotation. So next two degrees of freedom are theta B and theta C. So accordingly, the total degree of freedom are 3. Okay, one is delta. Translation at this beam level, that is the translation, it is for these two column, delta B and delta C, both are same. Therefore we are taking that delta B delta C with this single term, simply delta. And next, rotation at joint B and rotation at joint C. So these are the 3 degrees of freedom. Now one by one we will calculate all matrices of this compatibility equation which is used in structure approach, that is ADL. AD is equal to ADL plus K into D matrix. Okay, so let us calculate step number 2, calculation of AD matrix. Okay, so this AD matrix, it will contain, it is a column matrix which will contain the 3 elements. Those are corresponding to these 3 degrees of freedom sequentially. So let us see the action corresponding to these 3 degrees of freedom. So first degree of freedom is delta. Action corresponding to this delta, it is force or whatever reaction at B and C, that is horizontal reaction. Okay, because that delta, it is the horizontal deformation. So action corresponding to that delta, it should be horizontal force or reaction at B and C point, that is at beam level. Second degree of freedom is theta B. Action corresponding to this theta B, it is moment at B. And third, theta C. So action corresponding to this theta C, moment at C. So these 3 points that we have to write here in this AD matrix sequentially from original structure. AD matrix, that is action corresponding to displacement or unknown displacement from original structure. So see, in original structure, the first, is there any force at B and C point? So in original structure at B point there is a force. At beam level, this 50 kN. So that force you have to write here as per the sign convention. This force, it is in right direction, right? Therefore, positive. We consider right direction positive, left direction negative. So write here 50 kN force, which is action corresponding to this delta. If Any another force present at C point, it may be in left direction, may be in right direction. So that force you have to algebraically add in this 50 and write that answer here. Okay, if any force is present at C point, in that case you have to add these two horizontal forces at B and C point according to their sign convention and write here as the action corresponding to this delta in this AD matrix. Okay, so first point, first element that we have calculated, that is written here 50. Now second element, theta B, action corresponding to theta B, that is moment at B point. So in original structure, is there any moment at B point? No. So write here 0. Similarly, action corresponding to theta C. So here also, as no moment is present at C point in original structure, so again the third element is 0. Okay, so this AD matrix, that is completed. Action corresponding to displacement in original structure. Now third step, that is calculation of this ADL matrix. Step number 3. ADL matrix, that is action corresponding to unknown degrees of freedom, unknown displacement from restrained structure. So here first we need to draw the restrained structure. We have to calculate all reaction and moment for that restrained structure, that is fixed end moment and their associated reaction at each point, each node, and then we'll write this ADL matrix as per this sequence. Okay, so here first member, AB member, as AB member is subjected to no any force, so all moment are 0 here. Also, reactions are 0. Similarly, for CD member that is also subjected to no any load, there is no any point load, concentrated load, also UDL. So also, for this CD member, all moments and reactions are 0. And last remaining, that is this beam BC, which is subjected to this 75 kilonewton load at center. So here we know that moment, fixed end moment, restrained moment because of point load which is acting at center, that is WL by 8. So calculate that 75 into L, that is 844 divided by 8. So 8 gets cancelled. Answer is 75. So here this BC member names are remaining. So BC member, this moment is 75 kilonewton anti-clockwise, CD moment 75 clockwise, and their reaction, to calculate the reaction, use summation of moment about B or C equal to 0 and summation Fy equal to 0. So you will get these reactions as this reaction, vertical reaction at B point and C point. So if you take the moment at B, 75 positive, 75 negative, they will cancel each other. Moment of this 75 about B, 75 into 4, and moment of this RC into 8. So this reaction, that will be equal to 75 divided by 2, 37.5. So this reaction 37.5 kilonewton. Okay, summation Fy equal to 0, from that you will get this reaction. Now, all moments reactions are calculated. Now you have to write ADL matrix. So we'll write here ADL matrix. So there will be, it is a column matrix containing three elements. Those elements corresponding to these 3 degrees of freedom. So sequentially, the very first, that is force or reaction at B and C. Okay. Delta, that is horizontal. Delta is horizontal. So it should be a horizontal reaction or force at B and C point. And C, horizontal reaction, it is only for column. Horizontal reaction is only for column. So C for column. Beam is subjected to only this vertical reaction. Beam is subjected to only this vertical reaction, and we want here in ADL matrix, ADL that is action corresponding to 3 degrees of freedom, these unknown degrees of freedom from restrained structure. From restrained structure, see horizontal force at B and C, which will be only for the vertical member, that is for column. So here this column, it is not subjected to any load, therefore these reactions are zero. So write here this as zero. Now suppose in case these members AB and CD, if it is subjected to any load, whatever the type of load, concentrated load, UDL, UVL, so in that case there will be some reaction at this point. Okay, so here while calculating this element action corresponding to this delta, so in that case you need to add these two reactions algebraically, that is reaction at B point, reaction at C point, horizontal reaction, add according to their sign convention and write down that total here. So that will be the element action corresponding to this delta. Now second, action corresponding to theta B, that is moment at B point. So see here in restrained structure, for AB member the moment is zero here, for BC member at B point this is the moment. So this moment, it is in anti-clockwise direction 75 kilonewton. So right here this 75. And third element, action corresponding to theta C, that is moment at C point. So see here at C point, what is the moment here? So at C point for CD member this is zero value, at C point for this BC member this 75 in clockwise direction. So right here in clockwise direction this minus 75. So this is your ADL matrix, action corresponding to these 3 degrees of freedom from restrained structure. Okay, now step number 4, that is calculation of K matrix. Now here for calculating K matrix, that is stiffness matrix, so order of this matrix will be 3 by 3, as degree of freedom is 3. And to calculate those elements, total 9 elements, the procedure is to take this each degree of freedom equal to 1 by 1. Okay, so let us take delta equal to 1, draw the figure, calculate these 3 elements from each figure. Second figure, that will be when theta B equal to 1, draw that figure, calculate associated moment and reaction, and for that figure write down again these 3 elements, and similarly do for when theta C equal to 1. So that is the procedure in structure approach for calculation of this, that K matrix. So let us take the very first degree of freedom, that is delta equal to 1. So here let delta equal to 1, delta that is sway for column. The beam will not be subjected to any sway here, only columns are subjected to sway, vertical members. So here draw that figure. So I'll draw those members separately. This is AB member, BC member and CD member. Okay, so as delta, it is contributed only to the vertical members as axial deformation is neglected. So this BC member will remain as it is. Only these two columns are subjected to sway. So give this deformation, this translation in positive direction, that is in right direction. So here giving delta at B point and at C point, so here this will deflect in this direction. So this member will take this type of shape, these two vertical members. Okay, now here I is given for this member, it is I, and length is given 4 meter. Okay, so this inertia, if it is varying, that you have to count here in this moment, that is rotational sinking stiffnesses. So here the moment generated, that is 6 EI upon L square, 6 EI upon L square. So here at both ends. So as length is same, so that stiffness will be 6 EI upon L square, that is 6 divided by 4 square. So that is equal to 0.375. So right here 0.375 EI, 0.375 EI. Similarly here 0.375 EI, that moment, and 0.375 EI. Okay, moments are calculated. Now reaction, because that reaction it is, we require at B point and at C point horizontal reaction as action corresponding to delta. So that will be element, the very first element in our K matrix. So reactions, see these moments are in an anti-clockwise direction. Okay, these moments are in an anti-clockwise direction. So reaction should form clockwise couple. Therefore reaction at B, it must be towards right, and reaction at A must be towards left. Then and then it will form this type of clockwise couple. Okay, and magnitude of moments will be addition, magnitude of reactions, that is 6 EI upon L square, 6 EI upon L square addition divided by length. So that magnitude will be equal to 12 EI upon L cube, 12 EI upon L cube. So 12 divided by length is 4, 4 cube. So that is equal to 0.1875. So that is the reaction magnitude here, 0.1875. 0.1875 EI. Okay, now similarly for this CD member, as length is same, inertia is same, so reactions will also be same. So here 0.1875 EI, and here also 0.1875 EI. Okay, now once this figure is completed, now we'll write down the first column of this K matrix. Okay, so here write down these three elements accordingly. Those we have written here. Force or reaction at B and C point. Moment at B. Moment at C. Okay. So write down these three points. Force at B and C. Moment at B. And third, moment at C. So see, in this figure, when delta is equal to 1, when delta is equal to 1, what is the force at B and C? So see here, the force, that is reaction, 0.1875, 0.1875. So addition of these two moments, because both are in right direction, so that element will be positive. So 0.1875 plus 0.1875 EI. Okay, so that value is equal to, that is 0.375 EI. 0.375 EI. Now moment at B. See this moment at B in anticlockwise direction. So right here 0.375 EI. And similarly moment at C. This moment at C, that is 0.375 EI. Okay. So this will form the first column of this K matrix. Okay. That we know the procedure how to write the K matrix. There will be total 9 elements. This K is equal to 3 columns, 3 rows. The very first column that is written when delta is equal to 1. Second column is written from the figure of when theta B equal to 1. And third column is written from when theta C equal to 1. And each element in that figure, it will be corresponding to this 3 degrees of freedom. Action corresponding to this 3 degrees of freedom. So here this first column, action corresponding to delta, that is this one, force at B and C. Second, action corresponding to this theta B when delta equal to 1, that is moment at B. And third point, action corresponding to theta C, that is moment at C. So these elements, they will form the first column of this matrix. Now similarly, we have to draw the second figure when theta B equal to 1. And similarly, write down these three points as second column. Okay. Now let us see second next step, that is when theta B is equal to 1. when theta b equal to 1. Okay, so that time theta b rotation at b, when we are giving the rotation at b, that time only AB member and BC member will be rotated. CD member will remain as it is because B point, which is common to AB and BC member. So here let us draw that figure. This is AB member, BC member, and here this CD member. Okay, so CD member that will remain as it is. AB member, we are giving this unit rotation in positive direction, that is in anti-clockwise direction. So when you rotate this end B in anti-clockwise direction, in this direction, in anti-clockwise direction, so this member, it will be rotated this way. Okay, theta B equal to 1. And similarly, the B end, because of giving unit rotation in positive direction, this member BC, that will be rotated in this direction. Okay, that is theta b equal to 1. Okay, so this will be the figure. Now, here for both members, you have to calculate this near end, far end, near end, far end moments and calculate these reactions, associated reaction from these moments. So that we know. So here BC member, EI is given 2 times EI. Length is given 8 meter. For AB member, I is single I and length is 4 meter. For CD member, length is 4 meter, I is single I. Okay, so let us calculate for AB member first. So here this near end stiffness, that is 4 EI upon 4, that is simply EI. And this side, 2 EI upon L, that is 0.5 EI. Okay. Now for this BC member, this is 4 EI upon L. So 4 into 2, okay, that we have to consider. 4 E into 2 I divided by length of member 4 EI upon L, that is L. So 4 into 2, 8, 8 divided by 8, that is equal to EI. Okay, and this side 2 EI upon L. So 2 into 2 I divided by 8 meter. So this will be equal to 4 divided by 8, 0.5 EI. Okay. So these are the moments for both members, near end, far end moment. Now calculate the reaction. What we want? Reaction only at B and C point. So there is no need to calculate reaction for this BC member because those reactions are vertical reaction. And we want delta, action corresponding to that delta as horizontal reaction. Therefore, calculate horizontal reaction only for these vertical members. So, see here, these moments are in anti-clockwise direction. So, reaction should form clockwise couple. So, reaction at B should be in right and at A it should be in left direction. And magnitude, addition of moment divided by span. So, this 4 EI upon L plus 2 EI upon L divided by length. So magnitude will be 6 EI upon L square. So 6 divided by 4 square, that is 0.375 EI. And here also 0.375 EI. Okay. So that is 6 EI upon L square magnitude. Now figures are completed. Now write down those three elements. That is when theta b equal to 1. What is the action corresponding to theta b and theta c, that is force at B and C. The second action corresponding to theta b, that is moment at B. And third action corresponding to theta c, that is moment at C. Okay, these three elements from this figure, that is when theta b equal to 1. So very first, force at B and C. So at C there is no force, C only B point. So here at B point, horizontal reaction 0.375 EI. Action corresponding to delta. Second, moment at B. So moment at B, so that is present in both figures here for AB member, BC member. So directly do the summation. Both are in anti-clockwise direction. So addition, this EI plus this EI, that is equal to 2 EI. Okay. And last, moment at C. So moment at C, this is anti-clockwise, 0.5 EI. Okay, so this is the second column of K matrix. Now, last remaining, that is when theta C equal to 1. So when theta C equal to 1, AB member, CD member and this BC member. Okay, so here when we are giving theta C equal to 1, that time this BC and CD will be rotated only. This AB member will remain as it is because C, this point, it is common to these both members. So let us give this unit rotation at C point in positive direction, that is in anti-clockwise direction. So here in anti-clockwise direction, in this direction, this member, okay, you can see in this way, the arrow that is moving that member, rotating that member in this direction. So this member get deflected in this direction. Similarly here, this theta C equal to 1. Similarly for BC member, when we are giving unit rotation in positive direction, that time this arrow, it is moving that member in downward direction. So here this will form this type of shape. So here this theta C equal to 1. Okay. Now as we have done here calculation of this, so similarly do here near end, far end moments. So here this moment 8 meter, 2i inertia. So this 4 EI upon L. So 4 into 2 divided by 8. So that is equal to EI. And this side 2 EI upon L, that is 0.5 EI. Now for this CD member, I is I, inner length is 4 meter. So this near end moment in anti-clockwise direction, 4 EI upon L, 4 EI divided by length 4. So that will be equal to EI. And at D, 2 EI upon L, that is 0.5 EI. Now reaction, we want only horizontal reaction. Do not calculate for BC because reaction for BC are vertical. Only reaction for CD, those will be horizontal. These moments are in anti-clockwise. Reaction couple should be clockwise. So reaction at C and D, they should be in the direction shown here. Then they will form this clockwise couple. And magnitude of these reactions will be 6 EI upon L square. So 6 divided by 4 square, that is 0.375 EI, 0.375 EI. Okay, so these figures are completed. Now write down the third column, that is force at B and C, moment at B and third moment at C. That is the three elements of stiffness matrix method. Sorry, this stiffness matrix K. So here when theta C equal to 1, what is the reaction or force at B and C? So for AB member, that is not subjected to any rotation because of theta C equal to 1. So here no reaction at B. Now for this CD member, this is the horizontal reaction in positive direction. So write down here positive 0.375 EI. Now moment at B. So here moment at B, this is the moment in anti-clockwise direction, that is positive 0.5 EI. And moment at C, so these two moments are there, both are in anti-clockwise direction. So moment at this EI plus moment at this C EI, so that is equal to 2 EI. Okay, so here this procedure, that is to calculate the stiffness elements, that is completed. Now assemble all these elements according to their figure in column, so that K equal to, will take EI common outside the matrix, which is present in each element. So here this matrix, so very first column, that is when this delta equal to 1. So here we have written 0.375, 0.375, 0.375. So that will form the first column. So right here 0.375, 0.375 and 0.375. Okay, that is written when delta equal to 1. Now second, when theta B equal to 1, So when theta b equal to 1, these are the elements of second column, 0.375, 2 and 0.5. So right here, 0.375, 2 and 0.5. And last, that is when theta c equal to 1, these are the elements. So 0.375, 0.5 and 2. Okay. So now once we get this K matrix, now next step, that is after this 4 step K, then we have this equation. So write down this equation, put all these matrices in that equation and calculate for this unknown D. So here we'll write that equation again, step number 5, writing the compatibility equation, AD equal to ADL plus K into this D matrix. So AD matrix that we have written earlier, so that is equal to 50 0 0. Also this ADL matrix 0 75 minus 75. So write down here 50 0 0 this AD matrix, ADL from restrained figure 0 75 minus 75 plus K matrix EI into 0.375 0.375 0.375 0.375 2.5 0.375, 0.5 and 2. And last D, that is our unknowns sequentially that we have written in very first step, that is delta, theta B, theta C. Now solve for this one. So here taking this matrix on this side, so that will result into this 50 minus 0, 50. This 0 minus 75, minus 75, because we are taking this matrix on this side, constants. And 0, this minus, this side becomes plus. So here, this plus 75. Okay, equal to, this will remain as it is, EI into this K matrix, into these unknowns, delta, theta B and theta C. So putting in a calci all these values, equation, 3 unknowns. So very first, 0.375, and the constant of the equation, that is this 50. Second equation, second row, 0.375, 2 and 0.5, and the constant of equation minus 75, and last equation 0.375, 0.5, 2, and the constant of equation 75. Okay, so here these are the answers. That is, the first value is for delta, so that delta is equal to answers for the last delta equal to this 190.47 upon EI. Second value, that is for theta B, that is minus 78.57 upon EI. And theta C last 21.43 upon EI. Okay, so these are the last answers for our unknowns delta, theta B and theta C.